Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the third episode to create custom form using HTML and CSS. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. In the previous episode, we styled this input box and submit button. Today, we'll style this custom select box. So, first of all, let's remove this default arrow in select box. So, open your home.scss and you can add select and you can use appearance none. If you want cross-browser compatibility, you can add webkit appearance none and moz appearance none. So this applies for Chrome browser and this applies for Firefox browser. Let's check the site now. And you can see the arrow has been removed now. But if you check in IE, this arrow is still over here. So to remove them from IE, you have to add MS expand and you have to use display none. So let's refresh again in IE and the arrow has been removed. Great. Now let's add some styling in the select box like font, background, color, border and so on. So first, I want to apply font. The font size would be 16px. The line height would be 1.6. And to use the Roboto font, I'll just use the variable name. Then for background, I want to use secondary color. For my text color, I want to use black. For border, I want to use 1px solid. And I want to darken my secondary color by 15%. Then I want to apply 100% width and 100% height. So I will do 100% width and 100% height. Finally, I want to add cursor pointer over here and add some padding for this icon. So let's add cursor pointer and let's add padding. The top padding would be 0, the right padding would be 45px, bottom would be 0 and left padding would be 15px. Refresh the site now and the width is still not 100%. So let's do one thing over here. In this parent div call, we can add 100% width and some height. So I will add a call class. And for this call class, I will use 100% width and 45px height. I want to use this parent class name as well, select, so that it would apply only for this select box. So I will cut this again. I will add a select class name and paste everything inside. You can refresh the site again. And this time it is looking much better. Now, let's add this triangle icon and this box using before and after pseudo element. So, using before pseudo element, we will style this box, and using after pseudo element, we will style this triangle icon. So first, let's style this box. So over here, you can use before pseudo element, and whenever you use before or after pseudo element, you have to use content. Then we need a background, and for the background I want to darken my secondary color by 15%, and I want to apply the width of 30px. Then I want to apply position so that it would be always on the right side of the select box. So I will apply position absolute. So from top I want to apply 1px, from right I want to apply 1px, and from bottom I want to apply 1px. So whenever we use this position absolute, we have to use position relative in the parent element. So over here I want to use position relative. Once done, you can check the site and you should see a box over here. Then finally, if you want to remove this pointer, you can use pointer events none. Refresh the site again, and this is looking nice. Now let's style this triangle icon, and to style them there is a site. So you can just search CSS triangle, and you can click on the CSS triangle generator. Then we want the bottom, this kind of design. So once done, you can copy all of the CSS and add them in After Studio element. So again, we need a content. Then you can paste your code. Now for this color, we want the white, so you can change it to white. And for border width, instead of 100px, I just want 5px. Then again, I want to apply position. So I will apply position absolute. From top, I want to apply 0, and from right, I want to apply 10px. And again, I want to use pointer events none. Once done, you can check the site. And you should see a triangle icon over here. If you want to keep them at the middle, for top you can use 50%, and then we just need to add transform, translate y, and negative 50%. So let's update this code. Refresh the site again. And this time it is looking exactly the same as in our design. But if we click on them, we have got this black outline. To remove them, you can use a focus state and add outline none. Refresh the site again. And this time, everything is looking perfect. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll style the custom radio button. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.